Rumors of the iPhone arriving on Verizon are storming the web. eBay launches a new classified site and a USB stick that self-destructs if tampered with. It's Wednesday, March 31st. I'm Natalie Del Conte, and it's time to get loaded. The blogosphere went crazy yesterday on rumors that Apple could be releasing a new iPhone for Verizon soon. The Wall Street Journal reported this based on sources briefed by the company. They said a new iPhone could work on a CDMA network, which is the network used by Verizon or Sprint and others, rather than AT&T's GSM networks. Now, this does not necessarily mean that Verizon is going to get the iPhone, but it's everyone's pipe dream. All speculation, but Apple shares soared from this news on Tuesday, so speculation is powerful. Yahoo is now part of the Google China debate. Foreign journalists in China reported that their Yahoo email accounts were hacked. A similar occurrence was reported for Gmail just a few weeks ago. The journalists could not log into their accounts because someone had broken in. Yahoo does not appear to be as put out about this as Google was, in as far as we can tell. Twitter's homepage now has more than just a login. It also has tweets from some notable tweeters, as well as information on what people are discussing. This will refresh every few seconds and be selected by Twitter's own algorithm that shows popularity of people and topics. It will also scroll highlights for suggested sources and trending topics. This is a slow rollout, and of course, you won't see any of it if there's a fail whale, which does happen less and less these days anyway. eBay unveiled a new classified site called eBay Classifieds. This will replace Kijiji, their old classified site, and obviously compete with Craigslist. Kijiji, not really a big hit in the US, but it actually does well in other countries like Canada and Australia, so in those countries it will keep the name. Here in the US, the site will have two new mobile apps, one for selling and one for buying, and also an iPad app when that comes out on Saturday with the actual iPad. These are regional classifieds, of course, so you can test drive it yourself at ebayclassifieds.com. If you want turn-by-turn navigation on the iPhone, you can find it for free in the new MapQuest app. This is an update to MapQuest Mobile, not MapQuest Navigator, which always had spoken turn-by-turn. It should tide you over if you need spoken directions, at least until the iPhone gets native turn-by-turn, which I suspect it should in the next generation. You can now pay for your coffee with the Starbucks mobile app, but only if the Starbucks in question is inside a Target store. The Starbucks mobile app usually just gives you information about your card so you can reload it or whatever, but usually a barista can't actually charge that until now. In Target stores, baristas will be able to scan a QR code, and that will deduct the price of your drink from your Starbucks account. I suspect this will roll out to other stores eventually. And if you don't know what a QR code is, watch my help and how-to video from last week here on CNET. You can now share documents right in your chat window if you're using Google Chat in iGoogle or Orkut. This is a nifty little update for sharing pictures, documents, or other files right from chat. It does not work in the chat client within Gmail yet, unfortunately, but Google says that will happen soon. This guy gets the prize for worst neighbor to have if you love technology. Arthur Furstenberg is suing his neighbor for $530,000 because she uses too many gadgets on her home Wi-Fi network, and he thinks that's making him sick. His symptoms include nausea, vertigo, body aches, dizziness, heart arrhythmia, and insomnia. This is the same guy that started a petition to have the city ban municipal wireless because he thinks it's hazardous to his health. His poor neighbor used an iPhone, a laptop, a wireless router, and dimmer switches. He asked her to cut down on devices, and she told him to basically take a hike. Now, I don't want to make fun of someone who obviously does believe that his health is being jeopardized, but there is no medical basis for the fact that Wi-Fi is bad for your health, and I can imagine that if my neighbor asked me to cut down on my home network usage, I would not have a kind response for him. A new USB stick will self-destruct if someone unauthorized tries to break into it. Victorinox, the maker of the Swiss Army knife, launched a new memory stick that has fingerprint identification, a thermal sensor, and a self-destruct mechanism. It starts at $75 and comes in 8, 16, and 32 gigs. The thermal scanner is so that the stick knows that the finger is actually attached to a living human being, so you can't cut off someone's finger and fake this. There has to be an actual pulse. There were no details about the self-destruct mechanism, but I am assuming that it implodes rather than explodes like a bomb, or at least I would hope so. Those are all your headlines for today. Thank you for watching. I will see you tomorrow with more. I'm Natalie Del Conte with CNET TV, and you've just been loaded.